The Buzz with Jess Lujan.
Employing compliance is our issue tonight on The Buzz with, of course, Director Sam Abini and Jeff Saban, who's administrator for the Fair Employment Practices Office. Just before we went to the break, mm-hmm. and I know this is not basically your segment, but for the folks listening out there, mm-hmm. you know, where do they go to? They'll definitely come to, mm-hmm. to Department of Labor. It's probably another division, but what do you have to say to them in regards to that? Because they don't know it. This is taken away from me. My hours are taken away. Now my benefits are being taken away.
Right.
Do I have anybody to turn to, or can I turn to anybody?
Well, the wage and hour department mm-hmm. are the ones that make sure that employee is not that no violations against mm-hmm. the employees occurring mm-hmm. when it comes to the fair wages that they're supposed to be receiving. Mm-hmm. The question I think surrounds more around the impact and the difficult decisions that employers have to make to mm-hmm. keep their business running. Mm-hmm. Any extra cost to the business, whether it's a cost of utilities or the cost of supplies or the cost of salaries, those an employer has to make that difficult decision. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And that is the nature of, unfortunately, working in the private sector, is because mm-hmm. they do. If you and I had a private business, mm-hmm. we have to make those difficult decisions. And what we are seeing now, and not just on Guam, but in the United States, that many jobs are following a pattern of just part-time or consulting work mm-hmm. where no benefits occur. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So it's in my opinion that we as a community should look at different ways that we can offer employers ways to provide these kind of benefits mm-hmm, that mm-hmm. a lot of the people are seeking. Mm-hmm. The study that we had done regarding minimum wage did point out that one of the biggest concerns that that individuals have is their ability to receive not just the salary, but mm-hmm. the benefits in order to support their families. Because mm-hmm. with the lower wages that they have, that means that the cost to maybe bring their mm-hmm. child to the hospital is all out of pocket without benefits. Mm-hmm. So as a community, we need to sit down mm-hmm. and figure out different ways to make that happen. Mm-hmm. Now, your question earlier as far as a person feeling discriminated, maybe because, you know, is he not getting the same wage mm-hmm. because of this or that? I know that Jeff would have faced that question.
Yeah, correct. Well. Yeah, you know, like how Sam was mentioning earlier, as far as my department, you know, our jurisdiction is basically discrimination, unfair employment practices.
Sure.
How we go about ensuring and enforcing that with the compliance laws that mm-hmm. are provided to us, we just want to make sure that the individual or the employer understands exactly what their process, what mm-hmm. their job duties and functions are mm-hmm. to determine that the individual is covered and does not violate the individual's rights. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. very, very critical in terms of both the employer and the employee side, mm-hmm. knowing the laws, mm-hmm. understanding the laws, mm-hmm. understanding process, knowing where to go in terms mm-hmm. of guidance and assistance. Mm-hmm. One of the things too that oftentimes we get into our doors, mm-hmm. and individuals will come in thinking we're mm-hmm. attorneys. Mm-hmm. By profession, we're not attorneys.
Yeah.
We're just enforcement officers for the Fair Employment mm-hmm. under the Department of.
But let me ask you this. I mean, I think what you're doing is great for everybody to know, but it's not a requirement, right, for businesses, for people or individuals that are starting business to maybe go through a course for you guys and make sure that they're in compliance, that they know the rules. I mean, it should be a non-issue, right, that they should know the rules of engagement, yeah?
Well, that's a good question there. Basically, if it's 15 or more employees, mm-hmm. you are
required
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. to have the posters, uh-huh, uh-huh. you know, to have... mm-hmm. some kind of mm-hmm. training and mm-hmm. understanding mm-hmm. in terms of mm-hmm. what the law is expected of you.
Okay.
Oftentimes we get employers coming in mm-hmm. first time having a business on Guam. Mm-hmm. They're either not from Guam or off mm-hmm. island, mm-hmm. and they want to know what the laws are. So we give them a lot of materials, posters, information. In fact, mm-hmm. even the mm-hmm. labor clinics that my director just mentioned earlier, mm-hmm. we do those things. And the other thing is that we go outside our scope of duties. We mm-hmm. do outreach presentations. We go uh-huh. to the schools, the universities, reach out to the students coming out from college, let mm-hmm. them know there is unfair employment practices mm-hmm. in terms of interviews, mm-hmm. you know, so they understand exactly the questions that are being asked, mm-hmm. if it's discriminatory or not.
Mm-hmm. But let me ask you this as well, because again, as we say, you know, Guam is affected mostly by the Asia economy as opposed mm-hmm. to the U.S. economy. We have a lot of foreign businesses here, and you mm-hmm. know, foreign maybe the big companies, you know, they have standard practices basically, but maybe smaller companies, smaller mom and pops, you know, that's not how we do business, you know, in where we're at. How do we get them in compliance? They're not 15 or more.
Correct.
They're four or less. Yeah, like that. So how do you bring them in compliance?
Well, what we do is we, because mom and pop is mm-hmm. relatively small, they don't have the professional HR with them. You know, some of them will attend our clinics, some will attend the conferences, mm-hmm. seminars, others will just call. Mm-hmm. When they do call, you know, we ask mm-hmm. the total number of employees, mm-hmm. You know, ask if they understand certain rules, regulations, mm-hmm. Compliances, and mm-hmm. so forth. And, you know, when they're clueless to the questions mm-hmm. we're asking mm-hmm. them, you know, we call them in, we provide them materials, mm-hmm. information, we guide them, or we talk over the phone, mm-hmm. or mm-hmm. go down and visit them. Mm-hmm. One of the things, too, that when we do go visit their organization, mm-hmm. we look at the posters, you know, we look at what they have in compliance, mm-hmm. what is it, the best practices that mm-hmm. they could do in terms of recruitment, you know, mm-hmm. as far as what we are guided to mm-hmm. to do.
Now I know this is probably not your division, but you know, how do we get around that as well? Where folks, again, they you know, everybody tries to circumvent the system one way or another. But the folks, again, when you're talking about a smaller entity that wants to kind of get around there, but say, hey, I'm going to pay you a little more, you know, and therefore I won't have to minus taxes with that, right? But then they're working for a company, you know, for 10 years, and then either they're laid off, the company goes belly up, or whatever it may be. They find out down the line they've worked 10 years but never contributed to maybe Social Security. So those years are not counted towards that. How do we get around that? I mean, I know it's enticing that you're getting all your money and you're not giving Uncle Sam his due, right? It's nice to get it all, but you know, in the end, you've invested all these years towards that, and you're not contributing again to your retirement or Social Security. And how do we get around that? Maybe that's not your division, but I'm sure you know something like that. You know, a little bit of that, right?
Yeah, you know, that's a very isolated situation mm-hmm, there, mm-hmm. where an individual will come in and make that complaint in our mm-hmm. department. Mm-hmm. I'm not too familiar with how that will be handled mm-hmm. in terms of fair employment, but mm-hmm. that's something probably that will be you know, handled at the wage and hour okay. division as okay. well.
Yeah, but I'm sure, you know, I mean, the employer would be left with the bill if they're able to stay open, right?
Yes, and they can go to mm-hmm. an employee can go to the wage and hour division mm-hmm. and inquire. Mm-hmm. and see whether their rights would be, whether there's a case that they may be able to, that they could handle. I'm always about educating the average individual.
Sure,
I mean, most
sure.
young men or women who come out of high school don't realize mm-hmm, mm-hmm. The kind of benefits that they're entitled mm-hmm, to mm-hmm. when they work, like Social Security or
sure,
whatnot.
Sure.
So I believe it's important that education happens in the school, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. That education happens at the workplace. Mm-hmm. That's why our labor clinics are made mm-hmm. available for mm-hmm. employers. And by the way, these labor clinics are open to individuals as well. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Anybody should know what their employees should mm-hmm. be or should not mm-hmm. be doing. And if anybody wants to start a business, mm-hmm. these are the perfect clinics mm-hmm, to mm-hmm. to attend. But yes, that does occur. And if I don't know if you're like me, every quarter I believe I receive a letter from Social Security,
sure.
and it kind of lists down like what income you had. Those should not be put on the side.
Sure.
You know, you should
yeah.
look at it and mm-hmm. see whether in fact. Did mm-hmm. you receive what was entitled? Mm-hmm. And if not, then you can go back and possibly inquire to see what the employer should or should not have been contributing.
Mm-hmm. What are the biggest challenges here, Jeff, in regards to maybe the employers and employees out here? Guam's unique challenges in regards to them.
Yeah, the unique challenges that you know, based on my observation, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. is basically those that are you know, non-English speakers, those okay. that don't really understand the compliance, the nature of the law. We get a lot of Asians, you know, owners having mm-hmm. businesses, which mm-hmm. they, you know, oftentimes when we go up to them and we, you know, inform them about the discrimination, they're not too familiar with the law. So mm-hmm. what we do is we guide them, let alone also our brothers and sisters in the other islands, you
sure,
know, that
sure,
are non-English
sure.
speaker. They don't understand exactly mm-hmm, what mm-hmm, what exact the offense or mm-hmm, what the mm-hmm. discrimination is all about. We try to get, you know, somebody to interpret, somebody mm-hmm. to provide that information to them so they can understand exactly the violation or the infraction mm-hmm, that, mm-hmm. you know, has occurred. And
yeah.
if they did do it or they didn't do it, then we'll further investigate mm-hmm. the process.
And although they're not union, they have employee rights as well,
oh,
right?
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, let's tell the folks how they can get a hold of you if they have any questions regarding their employment situation, even employers, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Be right back.